या कुंदेन्दु तुषारहार धवला या शुभ्र वस्त्रान्विता या वीणा वरदंड मंडितकरा या श्वेत पद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युत शंकर प्रभृतिभिर्देवैः सदा वंदिता सामां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निशेष जाज्यापः वागीशाद्या सुमनसः सर्वार्थानाम् उपक्रमे यन्नत्वा कृतकृत्यासु तं नमामि गजाननम् गणानां त्वा गणपतिकं हवामहे कविं कवीनाम् उपवश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान् शृण्वन्नोति भिस्सीदसाधनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः नमः कृष्णाय शुद्धाय ब्रह्मणे परमात्मने योगेश्वराय योगाय त्वामहं शरणं गता కస్తూరీ తిలకం లలాటఫలకే వక్షస్థలే కౌస్తుభం నాసాగ్రే నవమౌక్తికం కరతలే వేణుం కరే కంకణం సర్వాంగే హరిచందనం చ కలయం కంఠే చ ముక్తావళి గోపస్త్రీ పరివేష్టితో విజయతే గోపాల చూడామణి త్రిభువనకమనం తమాలవర్ణం రవికర గౌరవరాంబరం దధానే వపురుల కకురా కకురావృతాబ్జం విజయసఖే విరతిరస్తు మైనవద్య నారాయణం నమస్కృత్య నరం చైవ నరోత్తమం దేవీం సరస్వతీం వ్యాసం తతోజే ముదీరయేత్. వెల్కమ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ టు అనదర్ ఎపిసోడ్ ఆఫ్ మై వీడియో సిరీస్ ఆన్ స్పిరిచువల్ మ్యాటర్స్. ఇన్ దిస్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు డిస్కస్ విత్ యూ వన్ ప్రెజెంట్ డే మ్యాలడీ, అండ్ దిస్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ అగ్రవేటెడ్ సిన్స్ ది 1960s అండ్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ బికమ్ ర్యాంపెంట్ నౌ. And because of this, many people are being affected. I have been observing there are certain indicators where a person is going after death. The present day trend has become this atheistic trend, which is saying after death there is no life, it is only one life, there are no more lives, which doesn't explain the real facts of life. I was born on the same day. He is born in a palace, and on the same day a person is born on the footpath pavement, and somebody else is born in a hospital in various ways. At the same time, if you take the world, people are born at different societies, different social classes, different affluence levels, different kinds of life. Why is this happening? The one life theory does not explain this. It is God, except saying it is God, mysterious, it is God's will. And in Hinduism, the God is not just merciful, all forgiving soul. God actually does not show or do anything except be a fair judge and dispenser of justice. Whatever you experience is because of the deeds you have performed, because of the duties you have performed, because of your actions, because of your words. Nothing comes to you just like that, either good fortune or bad fortune, good luck or bad luck, good experiences, bad experiences. They all come because of the deeds you have performed earlier in this life, and mostly in the last life. There is no God-given thing. It is all done by you. It has been clearly explained in Manusmriti and Garuda Purana in great detail, and in Mahabharata Anushasanika Parva and Ashwamedha Parva and all these Aranya Parva like that. Explained very clearly what actions beget what results. In a great detail it has been given. And in this, Hindu society is divided into four castes, and those four are Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. And in Mahabharata itself, Lord Krishna has said that Brahmins have to be treated as the number one caste. People have been disputing and criticizing openly and on the face of the Brahmins itself, that you are not good, you are not fit to be this. And the results have seeped so deep, even the Brahmins stopped feeling that they are Brahmins, that they have a special duty, that they have special dharma assigned to them to perform. And I have seen some Brahmin saying, no, I am not a Brahmin. They have come to the level where they disown their identity, they disown their caste. Very sad state. And in this, there are many places where Brahmins have been extolled and said that others have to respect them. I have seen plenty. Garuda Puranam it is there, Ramayana it is there, Mahabharata, 3-4 places it is there. While those places, they are told by people, other people, human beings. In Ashwamedha Parva, Lord Krishna himself said some things about Brahmins. I take it as standard because they are straight out of the mouth of the God himself. Krishna himself agreed that he is God in Mahabharata and Bhagavata. And others also, other characters in those two scriptures have also accepted Krishna as the God. He is an avatar. So his words, I am going to tell you now. And then you decide what you would like to do. It is still up to you. Because ultimately, no one is responsible for his actions except the self itself. Uddhareda atman atmanam. Atmanam avasadhayet. Atmanyeva atmano bandhu. Atmanyeva atmanyeva ripuratmanaha. The self has to be uplifted by your own self. Nobody else will come. And your self is the greatest friend of yourself. And the self is the greatest enemy of yourself. That is the way. That's why I am telling you about the what the statements of Krishna. To whom did he tell? He told to Yudhishthira. Yudhishthira has asked him some questions. When answering those questions, he told about Brahmins. Bhishma also told Yudhishthira the same thing. And Bhishma went to the extent of telling Yudhishthira, if one Brahmin starts in your kingdom, and if the Brahmin has to earn his own livelihood in your kingdom collapses. And Yudhishthira has implemented that rule in his rule and also in the descendants' rule. They followed that dictum for 174 generations. Then they deviated from that and their dynasty collapsed. Can you see the present day parallel? The rulers who have harassed, tortured Brahmins have all lost their kingdoms in maximum 4, 5, 6, 7 generations. Whoever treated them well, they get elected, re-elected, re-elected. I have seen many, some chief ministers from my own state, Andhra Pradesh. They have harassed, taken away the livelihood of Brahmins. What happened? Their death tells the total story of their life. What happened? They died in miserable conditions, separated from their family. Miserable death in the middle of the night, during a storm. Others also, the others also who have criticized and publicly rebuked and reprimanded and berated Brahmins have all died miserable deaths. And death tells the story how the person lived and to play, which place he is going. It is given clearly in Bhagavad Gita, in Mahabharata, in Garuda Puranam and other places. Most powerful. And take on the example of Mr. Narendra Das Damodar Bhai Modi. He respects Brahmins. He was elected 3 consecutive elections as the chief minister. 2 consecutive elections as the prime minister. That means 5 elections. He was consecutively elected with unheard of majorities. And his rule is going on. Here is an example of a person who has respected Brahmins and how he is prospering. 5 consecutive elections as the top man, 3 as chief minister and 2 as prime minister. And if all the indications are to be seen, assessed, he will win a 3rd election as the prime minister. A record all over the world. Why? People say many things. forget all of them, he gets only one thing. He gets the blessings from the Brahmins because he respects them. So let me read the slokas of what Krishna told and then you do. This is a video not only for others but also for Brahmins. I tell the Brahmins, behave yourselves. Follow the dharma set for you by Vedas. By veering away from the set path by Vedas, you are going to be born as the insect in your next birth. You don't do Gayatri, you don't take bath in the morning, and you go out and do whatever you want. Be ready for insect birth and 840,000 births before you can become a human again. You are at the top of the heap and you fall heavily. And first thing, let me also tell you why Brahmins are to be respected and to be treated differently. See, we have 840,000 varieties of life forms. In this, the lowest forms of life, the first birth is taken as the insects inside the waters. Then they progress towards all the births in the water. Out of water, you become the birds, flyers, flying insects, from flying insects to bigger birds. And once you complete all the flying birds, you come to the life of Tiryaks, or the animals with the horizontal spine. After spending all that, you enter the life of a human being, that too outside the four castes. From four castes, outside the caste, you come into Shudra caste. From Shudra caste, you come into Vaishya caste. From Vaishya caste, you come into Kshatriya caste. And at the end, after taking 839,999 births, the last birth is taken as the Brahmin. It is not easy. You have already spent all those births. We are at the top of the heap. You are like the soldier who entered the lowest rank and rose to the highest rank. When a soldier rises to the highest rank, all the other soldiers respect him. In officers also, when you enter the army as the first line officer and a general, general is respected by all the officers because he has put in the effort. He did not fall back. He grows steadily and attained that position. It is a difficult to attain position. That is why he is respected. That is why Brahmin is respected. I have not told you about the births of the stavara life. Stavara means static life. You don't move. They are trees. And starting from being a grass to a large tree, you live thousands of years in that. And then you enter the moving life, jangama life, stavara life to jangama life, and become an insect in the waters. From that you rise. So that is the reason why Brahmins are to be respected. They are at the top of the heap. You give them bad things, make them drunkards, and pull them down, they'll be going to the stavara life. So let me read the slokas from the Ashwamedha Parva of what Krishna himself said, and you interpret it and do what you would like to. Just a second. In Ashwamedha Parvam, after 92 parvas, they have an annex or appendix called Vaishnava Dharma Parva. In that, this is recorded in the third chapter. This is what Lord Krishna said, not my words. Na brahmanan parikshetha daive karmani dharmavit mahan bhaveta parivada brahmananam parikshane. When you are performing any rituals for gods, never test a Brahmin. Should not test Brahmin. By testing Brahmin whether he is fit to do that particular ritual or not will cause a lot of bad tidings for the tester. But when you are performing rituals for your ancestors, Brahmins can be tested. The rituals for the ancestors can be performed only by good Brahmins, and that can be tested. That's not a fault. But testing them for other rituals is fault. Shvatvam prapnoti nindhitva parivadat karo bhavet jambirbhavat bhitya bhavat kito bhavati matsarat. By berating Brahmins, the person will be born as an insect in the life, next life. And if you blame the Brahmin, that person will be born as a donkey. And these are the consequences of blaming and berating Brahmins. Berating will take you to insect life. And blaming behind his back takes you the life of a donkey. There is no alternative. Durvurtava, suvurtava, prakutava, susanskruta, brahmana, navamantavya, bhasmachanna, ivagnaya, durvurtava. Even if the Brahmin is of bad conduct, bad character, suvruttava, or even if the Brahmin is of good character, brahmana, navamantavya, you should not question the Brahmin. How will he be? Bhasmachanna, ivagnaya, a Brahmin is like embers covered by ashes, but still they are burning coals. That is what is Brahmin is. That's why you should never blame a Brahmin because he is dry as a drunkard, he is telling lies or he is doing something. Never blame such Brahmin. In my childhood I used to see the other people never said a word against Brahmins, but that has changed now. Kshatriyancheva sarpancha brahmanancha bahushrutam navamanyeta medhavi krushanapi kadanapa kadachana. Kshatriya, a snake, and a Brahmin should never be criticized or berated by any intelligent person, even if they are weakened. You should not try to laugh at a snake because that snake is not having food and is starving, or a kshatriya because he is not having a kingdom and a sword is not there with him, or a Brahmin, and that will cause you great loss. Yatha sarva swavastasu pavako daivatam mahat tatha sarva swavastasu brahmano daivatam mahat. Just as fire is sacred in all its forms, whether it is burning, whether the fire is doused, whether it is covered by ashes, whether the fire is covered by smoke, it is still sacred. And so is a Brahmin. Whatever stage he may be a young man, he may be an old man, he may be in the right age, he may be doing Gayatri every day, he may not be doing Gayatri every day, still he is sacred. Vyangya, Vyanga, that means handicapped. Kanasya, only one eye. Kubjasya, midget, with a hump on the back. Vamananga stadevacha, with bad limbs, non-symmetric limbs. Sarve daive niyoktavya, vyamishra vyadaparagai, without any doubt. Use them for rituals to gods, then let there be no doubt. They are all eligible. Manyum notpadayet tesham nacharistam samacharet manyu praharana vipra navipra shastrapanaya. Manyum notpadayet tesham, don't irritate them, don't annoy them. Nacharistam samacharet, don't do any bad things towards them. Why? Manyu praharana vipra, the weapon of Brahmins is anger. Be afraid of that. Navipra shastrapanaya, they don't bear any arms. Their weapon is anger. And the other person will be incinerated with that anger. Manyuna ghanati teshatrun vajrenendrivasuran brahmano himhaddaivam jati metre matrena jayate. Manjuna Granthite Shetrun, they strike at their enemies with their anger, just like Indra strikes at his enemies with his diamond weapon, the bolt of lightning. Brahmano hi mahat daivam, Brahmin is greatest god. Jati matrena jayate, a person can become Brahmin only by birth. Nowadays I am hearing that whoever does the Brahmin's work become Brahmins. TTD has been training non-Brahmins as priests. This is the specification in Mahabharata, told by none other than Krishna, that a person can become Brahmin only by birth, no other way. The other example in the scriptures is that of Vishwamitra. He performed years and years and years of penance to become a Brahmin. At the end of it, he became a Brahmin. Even then, in his birth, there is a secret by which he could become a Brahmin. Nobody else became a Brahmin. Only by birth. That's important. Brahmana sarvabhutanam dharma koshishya guptaye kempunarye cha kaunteya sandhyam nityam upasate. Brahmins are the custodians of the treasury of dharma. Then what is to be said about the people who perform sandhya vandana every day? Brahmins are the custodians of dharma. Nobody else is given that thing. So Brahmins have to be respected. Yasyasyena samashnanti hanyani tridau tridivaukasa kavyani cheva pitraha kimbhutam adhikam tataha. Theirs are the mouths through which the gods receive the havya, the offerings. Whatever offering you are making to God, it should go through the mouth of the Brahmin. What Brahmin eats, that goes to the devatas. What you feed to, if you want to give something to the God, you have to give it to Brahmins. Brahmins are the only vehicles. And the second is fire. You take, you spend a 10 million rupees and make a beautiful crown to Lord Venkateshwara, you get zero result out of it. You give that to Brahmin, you get 100 times that result. Kavyani, you are offering to your ancestors. I have seen atheists like people saying feeding a beggar is better than feeding a Brahmin in the rituals. No. These people are not having guts to tell on TVs. I'm telling now. And if required, I can come on TV and tell that also, no problem. Feeding a poor beggar is not equal to feeding a Brahmin whose stomach is full. Even if the Brahmin's stomach is full, he is the way, only way to send something to your ancestors, to gods. You may say 100 things. I am running a school, I am running a hospital, so many people are benefited. The results are meager compared to one meal given to a Brahmin. If you can satisfy a Brahmin, whole set of gods and ancestors are satisfied by nothing else. Utpattireva viprasya murtir dharmasya shashvati nahi dharmartham utpanna brahma bhuyaya kalpate. The birth of Brahmin itself is for the sustenance of dharma. And without Brahmin, this dharma will not be able to run. And that is how Brahma created it. Swameva brahmano bhunkte swayam vaste dadati cha andusanshat brahmanasya bhunjate hitarejana tasmate nama mantavya madbhaktahi vijasada. Swameva brahmano bhunkte, Brahmin eats his own food. Swayam vaste dadati cha, he is wearing the clothes that belong to him. Andusanshat brahmanasya, because of Brahmin's mercy, others are living and eating. Bhunjate hitare jana tasmatte namamantavya madbhakta his vijasada. The Brahmins are always my devotees. no doubt about it. Aranyakopanishadi etu pashyanti mam dvija nigudham nishkalavastam tan prayatnena pujita. The gods form is completely described in Aranyakopanishad, and Brahmins have seen it. Brahmins know that. That is why you put effort to worship Brahmins. That is what Lord Krishna told Yudhishthira, the emperor of the world. How you emperor of the world? From Denmark till Indonesia, the whole entire land was ruled by Yudhishthira. There was no other emperor like Yudhishthira, and there will never be another emperor like Yudhishthira. He ruled this entire landmass, Eurasian landmass, and above Sahara. All the African continent above Sahara, all the Asian continent, all the European continent. This was completely ruled by Yudhishthira, and that emperor, Lord Krishna told him, Swagruheva Pravaseva Devaratra Madhapiva Shraddhaya Brahmana Pujya Madhbhakta Echa Pandava. O Pandava, the son of Pandu, whether you are in your own house or you are outside your house somewhere else, whether it is day or night, Shraddhaya, diligently, Brahmana Pujya, worship Brahmins. They are all my devotees. Nasti Vipra Samam Daivam, Nasti Vipra Samo Guru, Nasti Viprat Paro Bandhu, Nasti Viprat Paro Nithi. Nasti Vipra Samam Daivam, there is no God equivalent to a Brahmin. Nasti Vipra Samo Guru, there is no Guru who is equivalent to a Brahmin. Nasti Viprat Paro Bandhu, there is no relative who is apart from Brahmin or equivalent to Brahmin. Nasti Viprat Paro Vidhi. Besides worshipping a Brahmin, you have no other duty. Who said this? Lord Krishna, the avatar of God, to whom? Yudhishthira, the emperor of the world. Nasti Viprat Param Tirtham Na Punyam Brahmanat Param. There is no Tirtha more sacred than a Brahmin, and there is no Punya than serving a Brahmin. Na Pavitram Param Viprat Na Dvijat Pavanam Param Nasti Viprat Paro Dharma Nasti Viprat Param Gati. Na pavitram param vipra, there is no sacred thing, more pious than a Brahmin. Na dvijat pavanam param, there is nothing more pious than a Brahmin. Nasti viprat paro dharma, there is no dharma other than worshipping a Brahmin. Nasti viprat paragati, there is no destination which is better than that of a Brahmin. Papakarma samakshiptam patantam narake naram Traite patram apyekam patrabhut tadvija. By doing sinful activities, sinful actions, sinful deeds, human beings fall into naraka. And traite patram apyekam, only one, ekam, that can protect, save a human being from falling into naraka or hell. Tadvija, only Brahmin can save people from falling into naraka. How? By receiving charity from you, by giving you his punya and receiving your sin and absolving it by performing japam, by performing sandhyavandanam, by performing all the actions required of him. Only Brahmin is qualified. When a person gives donation, the sin of the donor goes to the receiver, and that receiver has to cleanse that sin. Like you eat and the utensils after eating are put in the sink, and the person, the servant maid comes and cleans them. Brahmin can cleanse your sins like that. Nobody else can. Now no amount of charity. You wear Rudraksha, you wear gemstones, you go to temples, you immerse yourself in all the waters in the all the sacred tirthas, nothing will cleanse you. Deaths of the people are examples. I can tell certain deaths. a powerful man, a most loved person, he was shot dead by a Brahmin during the twilight time in the evening, for whom the last rites were performed not by the eldest son. That specification tells that this person is going to be born in 840,000 life forms. You know who that person is. Whatever human beings may say of him, even if he appears on every coin and every note printed, he is still living a life somewhere in the, among the 840,000 forms of life because of his death. However, I have already given made a video about the death and also the sins and the sinful actions that show up in death. Here is an example of one of the greatest persons of India, modern India. Only Brahmin can cleanse. Bala hitagnayo echa shanta sudrana vajjita mamachayanti madbhakya tebhyo datta mihakshayam. From the childhood, such Brahmins who stick to their norms, do not hanker after the food, like great food given by fourth caste, and they're devoted to me and worship me, whatever charity you give to them, it becomes eternal. It becomes infinite. That's what Krishna said. Pradhanai pujito vipra vandito vapi samskruta sambhavito va drushto va madbhakto devamunnayet. By speaking to a Brahmin who is devoted to me and giving charity to him, giving a little money, or just praise him, please him in any manner, and that will uplift the person to a higher level, elevated to that person to a higher level. Ye patanti namasyanti dhyayanti purushastumam satam drushtva cha sprushtva cha narah papaye pramuchyate. People who praise me, who sing about me, who talk about me, and who perform all these deeds, if they are touched, if they are seen, and the sins of the people will be cleansed completely by touching those people, by seeing those people. That is why some of the seers in India, they do not allow others to touch them, even their feet. Because by touching itself, the other man gets the cleansed of his sins. Why he is cleansed? Where will the sins go? This Brahmin will take over them. One practical example of such, Ramana Maharshi, somebody has come and cried with him, "I have sinned greatly." Ramana Maharshi said, "You give those sins to me, you are released, go." And Ramana Maharshi himself suffered heavily because he has received. Is an example in front of our eyes, very recent occurrence. Why Brahmins suffer? Because they are taking the sins of others by receiving the money, by receiving charity. Give them, you are getting an opportunity to get rid of your sinful actions. You will live happily, your next generations will live happily. Madbhakya madgata prana madgita madparayana bijayoni vishuddhaye shrutriya sanjatendriya Sudra Sudran Nirata Nityam Te Punantiha Darshanat. The good Brahmins who are devoted to me, who sing about me, who talk about me, and who are keeping good achara, good norms, they can cleanse your sins just by giving their audience. If you see such a good Brahmin, your sins will be cleansed just by darshanam. There are many examples I can give. Swayam nitva visheshena danam tesham gruheshvadha nivasaye nivapayet yadbhaktya taddanam koti sammitam. To such good Brahmins, you have to go to their house and give them. They will not ask you, they will not come in front of your house and beg. Brahmins do not do that. You have to go to their house, request him to receive charity from you, and then give them. Why will they not receive? Who would like to receive your sins? Of course, they have a duty to receive. A Brahmin cannot say no if somebody comes and offers something. However sinful person he may be, in my stupid days, when I was an idiot, I used to ask some Brahmins, why are you going and performing rituals in that person's house? He has been criticizing Brahmins left, right and center. He is using bad language on Brahmins. He has used all his power to suppress Brahmins to the extent possible. Why are you performing that? They enlightened me. Murali, he is an idiot. He can do what he wants. He is earning sin. We can't stop him. But my duty is to perform the ritual to whoever he asks. Even if that fellow is a sinful person, and even if he has personally caused losses even to me or to my children, I am still duty bound. I will do that. I will do my duty. That is Brahmins. People have taken away their jobs. People have taken away their livelihood. Still when they died or when they wanted, these people went and performed the rituals. That is a duty. That is Brahmins. And the charity given to such people, it is multiplied by 10 million times. 1 crore. Koti sammitam equal to 1 crore. 1 crore. That is 10 million times. That gets multiplied. How it should be given? You should go to their house, request them, and with all respect, give them, and treat as if he is doing you a favor by receiving your money. Indeed, he is doing you a favor by receiving your money. Along with your money and with your charity, he is receiving all your sins. Remember that, which is not sin.
Jagrata swapato vapi pravaseshu griheshvadha hrudayena pranasyami yasya viprasya bhavata bhara bhava.
Whether he is awake or whether he is sleeping, whether he is in his own house or whether he is somewhere outside, and that Brahmin, if he is not invisible to me, and he will always be seeing me, and to such a Brahmin you give.
स पूजितो वा दृष्टो वा स्पृष्टो वापि द्विजोत्तमा.
That person you worship. That person even if you see. That person even if you touch.
संभाषितो वा, are you talk to such person?
राजेंद्र ओ एम्परर
पुनातीवं नरं सदा.
And that person, that Brahmin will make you pious. Cleans your sins. So friend, this is stated by Lord Krishna to the emperor of the entire earth, Yudhishthira. This is nothing of mine in this. You can read this book yourself. It is available at a very low cost. Some 400-500 rupees, not much. I made this video not only for others, but mostly for Brahmins to realize their importance, to realize what they are made of, to realize what their mission is, and behave. Don't become drunkards. In this world, perhaps you may have to drink. You have to drink like it is water. A good Brahmin will eat everything, but it does not mean anything to him. He will not be intoxicated by a couple of pegs of whiskey. He should treat it in the same manner. He should not become a slave to anything. If forced, if the circumstances call for, it is called apadharma. He can do such things for apadharma, not voluntarily. Not voluntarily. I confess, I have taken drinks. I have taken alcoholic drinks. But not for pleasure. I never sat alone in my house and took. It is for a purpose, and because it is expected of me by my employer, by my friends, by the people who did favors to me, to please them. It is an apadharma, not desired, never desired. So friends, I stop my discourse about Brahmins with this. I wish you all the best. Swasti prajabhya paripalayantam nyayena margena mahimahisha go brahmanebhya subhamastu nityam lokasamasta sukhino bhavantu kale varshat varjanya prithvi sasyashalini deshayunksho varayito brahmanasanta nirbhaya putra putrinasantu putrinasantu pautrinah adhana sadhanasantu jevantu sharadam shatam shatamanam bhavati shataya purusha jitendri ayi srivendri pratidishtati shanti rastu tushti rastu pushti rastu sakala prakshkanam Sakala Sanmangalani Bhavantu Om Shanti Shanti Shanti